The Hunt Estuary is the most important shorebird site in New South Wales, and we're at a stage where we actually have to actively manage this shorebird habitat, because what we've seen in the estuary since we've seen development of the port is that the tidal prism has changed. So we're seeing a lot of changes in where salt marsh and mudflats occur, and these are the areas that the shorebirds feed. We've seen mangroves come up and grow in places that traditionally have been mudflats and salt marsh. And so what's happened under this project is we've actually got in and removed some of these mangroves in places that they shouldn't have been originally.
Our offset requirements relate to both green and gold bellfrogs and shorebirds. So early days it was, well, how do we go about this? Neither of these offsets are going to be easy to achieve, and we determined that the best way we could achieve them would be to engage with the stakeholders, those people who know about these species in the Hunter, and there's a lot of expertise in the Hunter. There's a significant amount of business risk in not achieving these outcomes for NCIG, so the requirement, the risk was there, so the effort was required.
In my lifetime, I saw these mangroves grow up and no birds were using them anymore except for things that use the mangroves.
The requirements related to a 2-to-1 offset around the disturbance area. And if you take the shorebirds, we disturbed 4 hectares of shorebird habitat. So our strict requirement was 8 hectares. Through working with our stakeholders, we identified an opportunity to get into an area that was degraded. And that area happened to be 24 hectares. But we decided that we'd spend that extra effort and money and get in and deliver a real solid offset, which adds real value to the Lower Hunter Estuary.
The engagement just isn't, you know, an email every 6 months or something. This is a continuing thing. It's, you know, I come out here every month to do the surveys, and NCIG have helped, you know, give access to the club to do those surveys. But at the same time, they've really engaged us with this project as well. So that's fantastic.
Our big win was the critically endangered species arrived. They were juveniles, so they'd come from the Northern Hemisphere, possibly Siberia, and arrived at our site the day after we finished. So that was a curlew sandpiper. Bellfrogs is a little bit the same, and we needed a couple of breeding seasons. We've now achieved 3 in a row. Nearly unheard of with this species, they're very finicky breeders. The scientific community for bellfrogs is pretty excited, and it's the longevity of the species we're all committed to, and this is a great indicator that species will continue to live on in the Lower Hunter.